Okay, good afternoon all of you. So today we discuss regarding the different properties of milk. Myself, Dr. Vikram Singh Ingle. So today I deal with the lecture, different properties of milk, that is the viscosity of milk, surface tension of milk, expansion of milk. First one, that is the expansion of milk. The expansion of milk is of a practical significance because of its bearing on the capacity of tank. Milk products which have entrapped air in them greatly increase in the volume as the temperature rises. However, even pure milk products increases in volume to a market extent. If the temperature of milk or milk product increases, volume is also increases. Surface tension. Surface tension affected by fat content, that is addition of a fat, lower down the surface tension. Surface tension of water, 72 dynes per centimeter at 20 degrees Celsius. Milk, 50 to 52 dynes per centimeter at 20 degrees Celsius. Skim milk, 55 to 60 dynes per centimeter at 20 degrees Celsius. Surface properties are involved in adsorption phenomena and the formation and the stability of a emulsion. They are relevant to creaming, fat globule, membrane functions, foaming and emulsifier used in the dairy products. Normally, cow's milk has an inherent surface activity. Its surface tension approximates 70% of that of water. The surface tension of a milk is usually about 50 to 52 meganewton per meter or dyne per centimeter at 20 degrees Celsius. The surface tension of a skim milk is 55 to 60 meganewton millinewton per meter. For a cream, it is approximately 46 to 47 millinewton per meter. Fat reduces surface tension by a physical effect. Lactose and most of the salt tend to raise it when they are present in a true solutions. Surface tension decreases as milk temperature increases. Processing treatments such as heating, homogenization, and shear tend to increase the surface tension. The next property, that is the acidity and pH. This is the very important chemical properties of a milk. The milk is acidic and the average natural acidity are as follows. Generally, the cow milk having 0.30 to 0.40% natural acidity. Buffalo milk having natural acidity 0.40 to 0.15%. The developed or the real acidity is due to the lactic acid form as a result of a bacterial action on a lactose on the milk. The titratable acidity is the sum of developed and natural acidity. The pH is another measure of acidity, and the pH values of milk are as follows. Normal fresh sweet cow milk having pH 6.4 to 6.6, buffalo milk 6.7 to 6.8. Higher pH value of a milk indicates other infections, and the lower value indicates the bacterial infections. The acidity and pH of a fresh milk varies with the species, breed, individuality, stage of lactation, and as the well on the health of animal. Then the next property, that is the refractive index. The average refractive index of a cow milk and buffalo milk at a 40 degrees Celsius are as follow. Cow milk, that is 1.346, buffalo milk 1.3477. Total refraction is the sum of individual refraction of the constituents present in the solution. The measure of the refractive index can be used to determine the adulterations, especially watering. Then the next property of milk, that is the viscosity of milk. We know the generally we know the what do you mean by viscosity. Viscosity, it means that it is the frictional properties of liquid, means relative motion in between two liquids. When two liquids are rubbing to each other, there should be some resistance offered in between them. This resistance is properties is called as the viscosity. Viscosity of a product is important from the standpoint of effect upon agitations and the rate of heat transfer in the pasteurizer or the heat exchangers. Material of a high viscosity require a large surface, slow moving type agitator to move them properly. High viscosity material causes a slow moving film on a heating or cooling the surface, thereby the greatly reduces the rate of a heat transfer of a given piece of equipment in the comparison with a low viscosity substance. The viscosity of a milk product varies greatly according to the composition, age and treatment. And generally the viscosity of milk decreases when the temperature is increases. Whole milk and skim milk display viscosities that is 2 to 2.1 and 1.5 to 1.8 centipoise. Centipoise, this is the unit of measurement of the viscosity. 1 centipoise, it means millipascal per seconds. That is 1 centipoise at 20 degrees Celsius. The viscosity of a milk and a cream creates the impression of a richness to the consumer from an organoleptic standpoint of view. The viscosity contributes to the mouthfeel and flavor release. Alteration in the size of any dispersed constituents result in the viscosity changes when the fat globules are greatly subdivided by the homogenizations. An increase in the viscosity is observed. The viscosity of a skim milk decreases on the heating up to 62 degrees Celsius, after which it increases apparently due to the changes in the protein hydration. An increase of the temperature causes a marked reduction of the viscosity. For example, at a 20 degrees Celsius, milk is about half as viscous at a 0 degrees Celsius. At a 40 degrees Celsius is approximately one third of the value of a 0 degrees Celsius. So these are the different properties of milk. That is, we studied the expansion of milk. Then the second property, that is the surface tension of a milk. Then acidity of milk. Then pH of milk and the viscosity of milks. Also the boiling point, freezing point, heat capacity, specific heat, these are also the main properties of the milk.